Hello and welcome to another video. Before I start, let's have a spot of breakfast. Yes, a triple sausage egg McMuffin. Okay, so today we're going to discuss, can you actually develop biceps peak? Okay, so let's go back to when I first started lifting weights, probably back in the early 1800s. We used to read the magazines and try and follow what the pros were doing. I mean, obviously now, this day and age, you've got the internet, so there's so much more information out there, although that in itself can actually be an issue because there can be a lot of misinformation out there. One of the things, I've always never really had a peaky bicep. So we used to look at what exercises could build that peak. And of course, one of the very popular ones was the concentration curl, which again, I'm sure most of you know what that is, and if you don't, you can Google it or put something in the comments below and I'll do a video on them if you like. So one day, a guy used to train in the gym, he was kind of the biggest guy in the gym, I started talking to him. I can't remember what he was studying now, but you know, he actually knew, you know, all the sort of physiology. In fact, that's probably what he was studying. And he explained the fact that the biceps is a two-headed muscle. Okay, so I'm just going to put a little image of the anatomy of the biceps there. So what he was saying was that you can't, if the muscle is this, you can't train in a way that's going to break the fibres in the middle and then just build those, the middle bits, and not the rest of it. You break the muscle fibres, then they grow to compensate for the load you put on. So let's bring that picture up again. Let me just move over. Right, here it is. So you can see you've got the two biceps heads. Okay, now what you will notice is what you would think was the short head, which is the outer one because of the way the deltoid comes across, is in fact slightly longer from where it originates and to where it inserts. So here's where the magic comes in. So if you have two things the same length, as you push them together, they get bigger that way. If one is slightly longer, as you push the two together, the longer one will get bigger that way than the shorter one. And that is a trick to actually putting some form of development on a biceps peak. So of course the next question will be, what are the best exercises to exercise that outer head, which is the one, if you put the emphasis out, as you probably know, as we're seeing, for instance, a very good example is things like training your chest. Doing an incline bench press will put some emphasis on the upper pec, if you like, but it will still train the whole pec. And the same thing with this. There are exercises that can target the different heads of the biceps, but yeah, only emphasize on it, not actually isolate it. The first one is grip width. Say you're doing a barbell or anything like that. With dumbbells, I suppose you can change your grip by doing this. So basically, the narrow grip will, I mean, you can do it if you actually sort of flex your arms while doing that. You can feel it just feels a little bit more on the outside bit. So that's the first way of doing it. So the second one, which seems to work best for me, is any exercise where the arm is actually, if you like, behind the torso to some degree. There are many exercises out there. The one I like is a 45 degree bench. So the main thing of importance in that movement is always to keep those elbows back. One of the temptations as you come near the top is to almost curl upwards. Don't do that, keep it back like that. So amongst other movements, you've got obviously the concentration curl, and then the other one that works quite well, if you can get it right, is called the drag curl. So as you curl, instead of curling up, you almost keep the bar against the body as you come up, like this. And again, if you even just try doing that now, you can actually feel that sort of peak contraction. So the way I incorporate that into my training is, I tend to alternate, you know, if you're in a building cycle, if you like. On one workout, I'll do my big compound, whether it's alternating dumbbell curls, I quite like, or heavy barbell curls. And then make the, in my case, it's the 45 degree bench lying curls that seem to do it for me as a secondary exercise. And then in the next workout, I'll actually use that as my first exercise. And I have actually seen, you know, over the last couple of years, a change. Not massively so, but actually in the shape of the bicep by doing this. So as I usually say with anything like this, providing it's possible, and in this instance it's building a peak on your biceps, yes it is possible, And it's also quite simple, just needs hard work. So there are other tricks for various muscle groups, including the biceps. Like, there is also ways you can actually create an illusion of slightly wider biceps from the front. That's for another video. So for that, or any other muscle groups that you'd like to know the tricks of developing them in a certain way, again, if it's possible, put in the comments below. I'm gonna wrap it up here. I hope you enjoyed the video and that it was useful to you. If so, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, give it a thumbs up, and until next time, hasta la vista, baby.